Good afternoon, the members of the jury and the respected dignitaries and the friends gathered here. Today I will be talking on the topic that is improving legal education through skills development initiative, opportunities and challenges for Bangladesh. Over the next five minutes, I will be dealing with the issues. Firstly, the relevance of skills development and its necessary for legal education. Secondly, the purposes of legal education in Bangladesh and some gaps in fulfilling the skills development program in the law curriculum. And thirdly, I will be talking about the opportunities to introduce skills development initiative in law schools. And fourthly, I will be talking also the current challenges for the law school to implement this initiative. And lastly, I will be dealing with the some best practices from regional and global instances to improve our legal education in Bangladesh. I would like to draw your kind attention to 2006 report done by Law Commission of Bangladesh. In that report, it was highlighted that law schools in Bangladesh are failing to integrate the practice of law for the law students. The report specifically emphasizes that the law schools should introduce some skills development programs for the law students so that they can work in the practice of law. And also, I would like to say that my paper is based on a small survey. I have conducted a survey amongst around 32 law students from 8 law schools of Bangladesh. And based on my findings, I will be highlighting that what are the poor conditions of legal education in Bangladesh. And also, it is to clarify that my paper is not suggesting that only practical aspect of law should be taken into consideration. Rather, I am suggesting that a practical approach can be taken only upon a strong theoretical base of law by the law schools. Now the question comes, what is the relevance and necessity of legal skills development initiative for the law education? I would like to say that skills, innovation and knowledge, these are three factors for national development for any country. And whenever the law students are getting the skills with the law schools, they will be contributing for the national development. And that's why skills development programs are relevant for the legal education. And there was a report by the American Bar Association titled Legal Education and Professional Development. And in that report, it was also observed that it is not only the responsibility of law schools, but also the Bar Council or Bar Association who should come forward and take the responsibility of developing a skills development initiative in the law schools. Now, talking about the purposes of legal education in Bangladesh, I would like to say that there was a policy in 2010 that is National Education Policy. But in that policy, nobody will find that the government has emphasized on the skills development initiative. Rather, the policy was focusing only the theoretical knowledge of law. So this is a gap in our policy level implementation. And also in our law schools in Bangladesh, there is no concrete objectives on the part of law schools. Therefore, often we see that there are diversities between the public and private law schools and also in their curriculum and teaching methods. Say for example, if I draw your kind attention to my written submission page number 30 regarding conventional teaching method, while I was conducting the survey, I raised a question to my respondents that what is the teaching method in your law schools? In my survey, it was revealed that 71% respondents say the teaching method is lecture-based, while interactive discussion was less than 10%, that is 7%, and case study-based class system was less than 5%, that was 3%. And if I also draw your kind attention to the traditional course curriculum, you will see that, say for example, in Dhaka University Law School, there is a course called Public Demand Recovery Law. But there is also a separate course that is law of civil procedure. But while these two courses are identical in many ways, so there is no, to my understanding, there is no benefit of separating two subjects, whether the law schools can introduce new subjects like law for nanotechnology, law for genocide, law for international criminal court, and so many things. Even there is a clear absence of multidisciplinary learning approach in our law schools. Even in Bangladesh law school, there is no such formal law review edited and managed by the law students. Only recent times, there was an initiative by Dhaka University, some students of Dhaka University Law School, that was Dhaka Law Review, though it was only limited to one like sphere. And regarding clinical legal education, there is no such formal legal education in our law, law schools of Bangladesh. Recently, in two law schools, that is Chittagong University Law School and Rashtriya University Law School, they conduct clinical legal education in collaboration with Bangladesh Legal Aid and Services Trust. Now, coming to the question of taking best practices of regional and global experiences, I would like to draw your attention that in Sri Lanka, there is a Council for Legal Education, which was established by the Act, which name is Council of Legal Education Ordinance 19,000. According to this ordinance, the council works in Sri Lanka to improve and reform the legal education. Also in Bangladesh, there is an institution that is called Bar Council. But can I have 1 minute? Thanks. But the Bar Council is not effective to improve its legal education, though it is mandated by its law to improve and reform legal education. So we can also think of revisiting the institutional capacity of Bar Council. And just to conclude my submission, I would like to say that SAARC cooperation is now necessary, but we also think of taking global practices. Since legal education has its unique characteristic in all the 7 and 8 countries of SAARC, so we should also go beyond and think beyond SAARC and to take the best practices for the professional skills development of law students. That's all from my part. Thank you.
Hello. Last point of you, that is, you said that it is necessary to have a cooperation between and among the SAARC countries. So I would just like to know, is it possible to pursue the best practices of these SAARC countries to overrule the misnomers, the social misnomers and cultural hegemony? Again, I quote these terms. Social misnomer and cultural hegemony. Like the Daniel Levy versus Union of India, that case played a very well role in Bangladesh because later on in 2011, we adopted best practices in favor of the women. Even we do not have any act, we do not have any policy due to social misnomer and cultural hegemony. So is it possible to pursue a regional cooperation through again and again referencing those best practices? That's all.
Thank you for your question. Like, I'm suggesting to take best practices. Now the question is why? Since there are diversities in all the legal systems of all the SAARC countries, we should obviously need to have a comparative discussion and comparative collaboration. And the best resource we can take, this is the SAARC forum. That's why I'm suggesting that to take the best practices of SAARC countries to improve our legal system, but not to sacrifice our legal education and our legal system. So keeping in mind the diversities what we have, the sui generis characteristics of our legal system and legal education, we need to go for the best practices that has been exercised over the years by the other SAARC countries.